So that would even include Teofimo Lopez wanted to come over and make an IBF. If he beats Richard Cohn, do you think he'll beat Richard Cohn?
Yeah, I honestly think that he will beat Richard Cohn. I think that he'll go in there, he'll make the adjustments. He'll use his speed, he'll be smart, and he'll beat Richard Cohn. A lot of people are saying Cohn is going to win, but I think differently.
You think if Teofimo then he's lined up to fight Loma. Would you see him winning that fight? Lomachenko?
Honestly, I don't see him beating Lomachenko if they fought. I do see it being competitive, but I don't see him beating Lomachenko. I think Lomachenko just has too many tools, and once his plan A goes out the window, Teofimo, his plan B wouldn't work if he would have one.
How do you nullify those tools? Because you yourself, obviously, you wanted the Lomachenko fight strictly to be a world champion. It's not like you were chasing him down in particular, but how do you nullify those tools, being that you feel Teofimo wouldn't be Loma, but deep down inside you feel you're ready for a Lomachenko? How do you nullify those tools?
I mean, if you watch Teofimo's last fight, I actually been in that ring with Teofimo, so yeah. I kind of know what he has and what he likes and what he doesn't like. But if you watch his last fight, you know, once he realized that he couldn't really knock him out, then, you know, he had nothing after that. You know, it was nothing. He didn't have a jab. He really didn't have that much head movement. But on any given night, we can have an off night. So in this fight with Richard Comey, we'll see if he gets up.
Yeah, I was speaking more in terms of Lomachenko himself. Because you said you feel that Teofimo probably wouldn't be ready for a Loma right now. You feel personally you are.
Yeah.
Where do you separate that? How you can nullify Lomachenko over Teofimo not being able to do it?
And that's what I meant. I was saying that, you know, I've been in the ring with him, so I've seen the tools that he has. I seen that, you know, that he really, you know, I wouldn't want to put any of his flaws out there, because I do think that he's a good fighter, you know, but I just... Being in the ring with him, I saw that, you know, I have much more tools than him. I have, you know, more experience.
We're to fast forward here. You said you're moving up to 140 down the line. Is there someone that you already have on your radar? For example, perhaps working with Eddie Hearn and Josh Taylor?
I actually talked to Eddie Hearn the other day about Josh Taylor. Maybe we can make that fight happen, you know, at 140. I really don't even know too many guys at 140. Like Ramirez. I guess those are the only two guys. But me having a WBC, who's the WBC at 140?
Ramirez.
So it's looking like, you know, maybe that would be the fight that would happen. And Bob was putting him in the ring with me. Me and Ramirez, we sparred before, like, you know, maybe like about a little bit less than a year ago. So, yeah.